There are few horror icons more unique than Coffin Joe. Murderer, rapist, blasphemer, heretic, grave digger, corpse defiler, misogynist, sadist, and all-around deviant existential villain. He's Brazil's national boogeyman, a wild top hat adorned filmmaker, top hat adorned Kate Undertaker, invented and played by an even wilder filmmaker named José Mojica Marins. So tonight, however, Rue Morgue and the Fantasia Film Festival take you back to 1964, to the birthplace of Coffin Joe, with this very special screening of At Midnight, I'll Take Your Soul. So without further ado, here to introduce this film, it is my great, great pleasure and honor to introduce you to the man, the legend, Coffin Joe.
José Mojica Marins, made this film, At Midnight, I'll Take Your Soul.
Bem, o que eu posso dizer é o seguinte, vocês vão ver o filme. Se gostarem, aplaudem. Se não gostarem, manda mais, grita, não.
Stay and watch, and if you like it, good. And if you don't, it's not his fault.
If you like it, you can applause. If you don't like it, you can
Depois da película, eu estarei à disposição para responder 13 perguntas. Eu tenho o número 7 e o 13 como cabalista. Então hoje vamos responder 13 perguntas depois do filme.
Stay after the film, because Coffin Joe will stay to answer 13 questions.
Leio a legenda e preste atenção na imagem.
Stay and pay attention to the magic that will unfold. And read the subtitles.
All right, everybody, what you guys think of the movie? So we're gonna have, I'm gonna introduce our translator, who is Coffin Joe's son. I hope I pronounce this right. It's Coffin Joe Marins, if you would come. He's gonna be translating for us along with Louis, whom many of you are familiar with. He's the owner and proprietor of Legendary Suspect Video. Come on up, Louis. And this man makes no apologies for any of it. So keep that in mind when you have questions for him. So, I bring you Coffin Joe.
He had during the production of the film? You mean in terms of the military interference? Did he have what kind of trouble did he have with the military interfering shooting the film back in the 60s? Or the church or the government?
Eu acho que tudo é problemas que não se pode ter. Cadeia, ser preso, não ter amigos, ter que ficar sozinho, porque uma roda de amigos me levavam novamente preso. Enfim, um homem perseguido, sem poder fazer nada e dependendo de alguns amigos militares que a mim que acabaram me ajudando, prosseguindo a eu mesmo o meu caminho com essa noite em cada dia de cada dia.
He said basically that everyone always had problems making movies and everything, and that he had the benefit of having some friends in the military assisted him in the production of his films, and but other than that, he was alone in his quest for making his movies.
Who's up next? Right here, red shirt.
Yeah. Were theaters in Brazil willing to show this movie when it first was made back at the time?
The theaters in Brazil, were they willing to show the movie? Were they happy to show?
Havia muita polêmica em torno do filme. Mesmo com a perseguição, o povo queria ver o filme. E foi feita a vontade do povo e os exibidores puseram a vida em papel.
There was such a demand by the public that theater owners had really no choice but to show it.
But it was only in our greatest series, because in some series that in the interior of Brazil, they couldn't see the film at the age.
Next up, I see a hand back there. Yes, you. Hi, oh Sean, how are you? So are you asking a question for Coffin Joe's views or the filmmaker's views, because they're very different? Okay. How does not Coffin Joe, but how has Mojica's views towards religion changed over the years?
Não há muita mudança. O fanático continua fanático. E o que não é fanático, não é fanático.
There really hasn't been much of a change. People who are fanatic stay fanatic, and those who aren't are not.
Question number four. I see a guy in a hat right here.
Yeah. There's been like stories and rumors, especially in his second film, that he would physically abuse
actors for a performance. Is this true?
Yes, I mean, that's true. But, you know, the pessoas para que elas atuassem, batia mesmo, as pessoas são reais.
Yes,
true.
Eu posso falar no Brasil, não. Eu falo no Brasil. Houve vezes que eu tive que bater. Mas quando eu fazia teste, a mulher já chegava e falava, não tem problema, pode me bater.
If you were to say so in Brazil, you'd be put into prison. But he did, and it was under the consent of the actors. So knew that what they were getting into.
Yeah, especially the women. Especially if anybody's seen the sequel to this movie, it gets even crazier. He abuses like entire groups of women and tortures them. Okay, question number, was I a five?
Five,
question five. I thought I saw a hand in the middle, right there. Long hair, yes.
What films or directors were you influenced by?
What films were inspiration to Mojica when he saw making this movie?
Quais filmes foram inspirações para o personagem?
Eu acho que não houve filme nenhum. Nasceu tudo de um pesadelo. Eu acabei tendo um atrito com a igreja, tive um pesadelo. Desse pesadelo nasci um personagem revoltado contra tudo, e aí nasceria Zé do Caixão. Não houve influência de nenhum diretor e nenhum ator. Eu só fui saber que existia Lonchalei, Libero Dose, Boris Karloff, depois que vi o personagem.
He wasn't really influenced by directors or films, but he was influenced by a prisoner.
I have a question. Maybe he wasn't influenced by filmmakers, but I know he was influenced by the EC comic books and the famous monster, the Filmland magazine.
Yeah, yes. Yes, my father likes very much cartoon. And he has still today a very rich collection of cartoons.
You mean comic books?
Yes, comic books. Yes.
You can see it in the beginning with the old witch that introduces the movie. It's very much easy comics. Yes. I just used up number six. Sorry, guys. Who's number seven? Right here.
Yeah. Was there a cultural background about the idea of a bloodline and immortality, or was that all the director's idea?
The philosophy of Coffin Joe about carrying the bloodline. Was this culturally influenced or entirely from him?
No. Essa é uma filosofia do próprio Zé do Caixão. Não tem nada a ver se conseguir com alguém é pura coincidência. E a roupa, eu posso dizer que a cartola e a capa foi inspirada numa viagem.
That is purely a Coffin Joe cultural construct. If it has anything to do with any other kind of cultural basis, it's purely coincidental.
That's my break.
Question number eight, I see.
Oh, and he is influenced by Mandrake in terms of his cloak. Yeah.
I saw a hand right in the middle. Yes, the slick back. No, behind. No, behind Gary. Yes, you. Was he taking drugs when he was making these movies? Is that the question you're asking, really?
A única coisa que conheço na vida sobre droga é o cigarro normal.
The only drug he's really into is the cigarette. Tobacco.
And men cigarettes.
Women are cigarettes. Earlier at dinner, he said, women are like cigarettes. You smoke them and then you throw them away. Okay, was that number eight? Am I on number nine? Okay, right here on the edge.
I heard that
footage censored and destroyed by the government? Is this true? And if so, was it ever found again?
Not this film. Other film.
Houve ameaça, houve fita que foram cortada como estranho mundo do caixão esta noite em Canadá de Alvarado, e houve um filme que ficou 20 anos preso. A fita que é considerada minha maior obra, eu só estou lançando hoje em DVD, porque na censura foram 20 anos.
He has had a lot of things censored, and in particular one movie that he made, which was held for over 20 years, and that was Awakening of the Beast.
Number 10, I believe? Question 10? I can't see out there, so you're going to have to... Okay, yes, you, sir. This movie? How long to shoot and how much was the difference?
Foi uma fita feita em desespero, foi a fita mais rápida da minha vida. 13 dias. No dinheiro de hoje seria 101 mil dólares.
This was actually one of the fastest film that he took to make. It took 13 days and cost roughly $100,000.
Question number 11, right? I'm sorry, right here? Yes, you, sir.
What's the women in the director's personal life? How do they react to the character?
Like your mother. Your sister, what did they think of the movie?
Todos os meus filhos hoje já estão acostumados. E o neto, quando vem, os filhos explica para os netos. Então já ninguém se apavora. No passado, digamos, há uns 15 anos ainda havia problema. Poxa. Olha, eu acho que as mulheres não se preocuparam muito. Ficaram com mais ciúmes, porque as filhas atraíam outras mulheres sobre José Mojica e não sobre José do Caixão. E isso trazia problema.
Women in his life, how they reacted was with jealousy because the persona would attract other women towards him.
question number 12, right here, sir.
Out of all the movies you've made, which are you most proud of?
Did you hear that? Of all of his movies that he made, which one is he most proud?
Por incrível que pareça, é um filme que está no meu box. De vez em quando é chamado, é um outro personagem que não tem nada com Zé do Caixão. Fins homens, um personagem diferente do Zé. Enquanto o Zé é um fanático violento, o outro é um religioso.
His favorite is called Phineas Ominous, and
I think my favorite and his favorite. Yes, it's a film named The Finis Dominis. I think it's not well known by the American people and Canadian people. But we have a DVD, and it's a special film because while Coffin Joe is a violent fanatical, Finis Dominis is something religious, is seen by the people as a religious. It's an interesting film, because my father usually says that Coffin Joe is a crazy, but he's conscient. And the Finis Dominis is unconscient, but it's crazy for the people. It's an interesting film.
All right, question number 13. Let's make it a good one. Oh, right on. Let's hear it. I know yours will be good.
I was just going to say there's been a lot of misleading information on the internet about his early films. I'm wondering, the first film he made, what was it called, what year, and how old was he? The first feature that played the theaters in Brazil.
His first film was not this movie. Mm-hmm. What was it?
That's it, everybody. Coffin Joe will be signing autographs upstairs for anyone who's interested. But other than that, thank you for coming out. And let's hear it.